Hello friends, welcome to Wired Digitally YouTube channel. This is Anil. In this video, I am going to discuss about joins in SQL Server. So before start joins, we should know why we are using joins concept in SQL Server. What is the advantages of using joins in SQL Server? So joins, before moving to joins, up to now how we can read the data from tables in a particular database. We can read the data, you can observe, we can read the data from a table by using select statement, column names. From which table you want to read the data? From a particular table. In this example I want to read the data from an employees table, so I can read a data. So you can observe, I have an employee ID, employee name, salary, city, gender, email ID, hire date and department ID, and you should identify it. And I have another table as a department table. You can observe how we can read the data by using select statement. In this select statement, each and every select statement can have different results. You can observe, at a time I can run the two select statements. You can observe, we have a department ID and name location in department table. We have employee details along with the department ID in employee table. But whenever we can read the data by using select statement, we can run different tables. Like a department table is separate, employee table is separate. Up to now we can read the data individual tables. And after that we can learn set operators concept. In that set operators concept, what we can learn, we can read multiple select statement data and we can combine those statement data into a single result set. You can observe, we can combine these two statements into a single result set. But here we can learn joins concept, because in a relational database we can store the data in logical tables. That means we can split the data into multiple tables and we can store the information accordingly. If you want to get a complete meaningful or set of data, how we can read? If example, we are maintaining the department data in separate table, employee data in separate table, but I want to know which department having how many employees, or which employee belongs to which department name. I want to get particular department name. For that purpose, how we can read, how we can get accuracy result into our result set by using joins concept. Because we can maintain the data in multiple tables and we can maintain the relationship between the tables in RDBMS part. Based on that relation, we can use joins concept to read the data from a multiple tables within a single select statement. But what are the prerequisites to work on? What are the prerequisites we should know before moving to the joins concept? Because there is a dependency between the tables should have master and child table, or else parent and child table relation. Master table or parent table primary key will be act as a foreign key in child table. If we can maintain these relationships, we can get accuracy or correctness of data into a result set. Okay, what are the types of joins we can use in SQL Server? In SQL Server, we can use multiple joins. You can observe this list of joins in the SQL Server. We have a SQL Server inner join. We can call it as equi join, natural join, or simple join. And also equi join, quite opposite, non-equi join. We can call it as a data join. So we have a SQL inner join. Either we can call it as equi join, natural join, or simple join. And inner join opposite as a non-equi join. And you can observe SQL outer join. In this SQL outer join, we have three types of joins. In this module, we have three types. One is left join or left outer join, right join or right outer join, full join or full outer join, and SQL cross join and SQL self join. Now we can go detailedly into the each and every join concept. Before that, we should know each and every concept and then we can move into the practical part. Now you can observe here. I have n. First, you can observe the concept. I have n table A and table B with ID columns. With ID columns, you can observe here. With ID columns, you can observe here. We can apply inner join. Inner join. Before applying inner join, what are the prerequisites we should know? It should be a common column between the two tables. Then only we can join multiple tables into a single select and return a result. So I have a table A, I have table B, right? And table A, I have ID column and with the below records 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And table B, I have 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. Inner join concept. You can observe inner join. Inner join is nothing but it display the equal number of values based on matching columns. So you can observe in inner join, I want to read, and at the same time I want to read a column from which table. As of now, I want to read a data from an A table. I want to read a data from A table data into a result set. If you want to be, you can use B table also. We can go into the syntax part. First, you can understood on the concept wise. I have a table A and I have table B. I have a two tables with two ID columns. So I can apply inner join concept. It will display the, you can observe, it will display the equal number of values into a result set. Inner join, it will display only matching records. You can observe 1 to 1, it's a matching, and 1 to 2, not matching, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 1 to 6, 1 to 7. Like this first record will be checking with all the records in next matched column, next table matched column. What are the matching values we have? These 2, 2, 3, 6, 7 is not matching, so it won't be displayed as a result set. Then 1 to 1 matching and remaining parts are not matching, and 2, 2 are matching, 2, 1 not matching, 2, 2 matching. It will display the result. 2, 3 not matching, 2, 6 not matching, 2, 7 not matching. And you can observe we have a 3, 3, 3 matching, and remaining values are not matching. If only equal values should be displayed in an inner join concept. Inner join, it will display all the matched records from both the tables, and it should be maintaining a common column in between the two tables. Then only we can use join condition. If there is no common column, we are not getting an accuracy of data. We can join, but we are not able to get accuracy result set. And then we can move into the left join. It's a part of outer join concept. Left outer join or left join, we can observe here. I want to read a table. See, a table ID result. Here I want to read a table ID result and B table ID result. So first remembering point, in left join it will display all the records from left table. You can observe this is my left table. I want to display all the records from left table, and which records are matching with the right table, it will display the matching records in the right table. It will display all the records from left table, and which records are matching with the right table, that records will be displayed from the right table. And which are not matched with the right table, in that place it will display the null values. And another definition also, it will display all the matched records from both the tables and display all values from left table. And if values are not matched in right table data, it shows null value. And then right join, can observe the right join. First it will display the, you can observe a dot id. What is your right table here? B table, right? So in the simple, quite opposite of left outer join, it will display the all the records from right table and display the matched records in left table and display unmatched values as null in the left table. So this is the definition of left join and right outer join. Inner join, it will display all the records from both the tables, and left join, it will display all the records from left table and match records with right table. If which records are not matched left to right, it will display null values. And right outer join, it will display all the records from right to table and match records with the left table, and which are not matched with right to left, in that place it will display the null values. and you can observe cross join. We can call it as cross join or Cartesian product. We can call it as cross join or Cartesian product. In that part, what is cross? Cross is nothing but a multiplication. Cross is nothing but a multiplication. Each and every row can be multiplied with another table, each and every row. So how many records we have in a table A? We have 5 records in table A, and table B we have 5 records. Totally it will display the 25 records in the result set. How it will be displayed? You can observe simple. I have checking with 1 and 1, right? 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 6, 1, 7, 1, 7. You can observe how many times it will be repeated. 5 times. Each and every record multiplied with another table, all records. 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into 3, 3, 1 into 6, 6. For every record will be multiplied with another table, each and every record. So 5 records into 5, 25 record as a output. And then what is full outer join? Full outer join. Full outer join is nothing but it will display both the tables data. It will display both the tables data as output. You can observe. You can display both the tables data as output. You can observe here. I have displayed the 5 records in A table, and B table we have 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. Now you can observe it will display which are not matched. It will display the null values. So this purpose we can use joins concept. Now we can move into the practical part on the employee and department table. Now you can observe we have an employee table and department table. You can observe here. You can observe here. We have an employee table. We have an department table. We have a department ID. This is my primary key in master table, and this is my department number foreign key. You can observe this is the primary key and foreign key. For this purpose, we can use it to create a relationship to join the two tables based on the common column. Now we can move into the practical part. So I have an employee table in my database. I have a department table in my database. Now you can observe here. First we can go to the syntax part. You can see in this syntax you can observe how we can get a syntax in joins concept. You can observe here syntax select. We have a single select statement with from table. Whenever you can work on the joins concept, first you can write select. You no need to write a columns first. First you can go to from clause and table name. You know, right? SQL processing steps wise you can write a queries part. First it will read the data from your table. In this table, which table you want to join, you can apply the join. You can apply the join condition here. You can apply the join condition here. Inner join or left join, right? Inner join or left join or right join or full outer join. So we are using the joins in between the two tables as required result set. Then on which condition you want to join these two tables on a common column, you should identify the common column before writing a queries part. So after identifying the common values, then you can go to select class. What are the columns you want to read from this table and read from this table? We can use it as a select list, and at the same time we can use where class, we can use group by, we can use having, and we can use order by. All these clauses will be supported into the joins concept. So we can, whenever we are writing a functions like string functions, date function, mathematical functions, null functions and conversion functions on top of an existing columns based on the requirement which you want to get a result set. That result set we can apply some functions and get an accuracy of result set. So you can observe here. I hope you understood the syntax of each and every join will be maintained the same syntax, but join conditions will be different as per the requirement. Now you can move into the inner join concept. inner join concept. You can observe here, I want to display employee along with the department details. First, you can, whenever you can write a joins, first you can follow some tips to easy to write a join conditions. What are the tables you want to get, like employee and their department name? So I want to join with the two tables, employee and department. First, I can note down employee table. You can observe, I can note down employees table, and first I can note down what are the columns, what are the key columns I have, like primary key column or foreign key column or any ID columns we can note down. Then employee ID, and I have a department ID in another column. So then I can note down another table, department. In this department table, I have only department ID column. I have only department ID column. Then you can observe what are the common columns in between these two tables. These two columns as a common columns. Now we can try to write a queries, but you can observe here, select star, not, no, don't write column names, select from which table you want to get employees. Employees as e. I can give you an alias name of this table, and which join you want to use. I want to use inner join. It will display the equal result into a result, so a result set, but it should be maintained the common column, department as D. And which condition you want to join on, what are the common columns in these two tables, department ID and department ID, on E dot DEPT ID equal to D dot DEPT ID. Now you can, what are the columns you want to read? I want to read E dot, you can observe E dot EMP ID, E dot name, E dot gender, E dot height date, and E dot salary. And observe, then we want to display D dot name, department name, right? As I want to give you an DEPT name as a column name into the result set, D dot location, and prior to that I want to display D dot DEPT ID. Either you can display DEPT ID from department table or employee table. Here in this result set, I want to display, I am displaying a D dot department ID from department table. Now you can try to execute a query, select a query and click on execute or press F5. It will return the result set. Now you can observe here, I have displayed all the employee details. You can observe department ID 10 20 30 10 20 30. Already we have a common columns in the result values. It will display only common result set, common result set. And another query you can write, I want to get each and every department wise, employee count, so select, you can observe from, right, from which table you want to get employee, employees as E. And I want to use inner join or join, either say both are same, DEPT as D, on E dot DEPT ID equal to D dot DEPT ID. So what are the common, what are the columns you want to get? I want to get employee, department wise employee count, D dot name as DEPT name, and I want to get employee count. How we can get a count? Using aggregate function, count star from star, you can give E dot star, either you can give E dot star or star, star, you can observe star, star as EMP count, right, from employee, from employee, you can observe. Now whenever we are writing a aggregated column with non-aggregated column, defaultly we can use group by class, group by, which column you want to use, non-aggregated column. In the select list, there is a non-aggregated column is nothing but a department name. Now you can observe, you can write. It will get admin, IT, sales. We have 2, 4, and 5. Next, you can observe, we have a, you can use left join. You can use left join. First, you can observe the result. IT, sales, admin, 2, 4, 5. Now you can observe the left join. How many records it will be displayed? 2, 4, 5. But I want to change this table as department and as a left table, and employee as a right table, employees as a right table. Now you can run it. See here, you can change D and E, D and E. Now you can write, see, there is a admin, clerk, IT, sales. 5, 4, 5, 4, 9, 10, 11, 12. But previously it will get only 11 records, but it will get more than one record. And also we can use where class, where e dot dept id is null. You can observe how many null records having the employee table. We have a employee count, one is a null value, but it will display the wrong result as clerk. So in this purpose we can use to define the joins concept, as we can identify it. Now you can observe there is no null values in our join part. You can observe, you can comment on where class, then you can apply the inner join concept. You can observe 2, 4, 5, but clerk is a one not matched value into the employee count. Now you can observe, we can working on the left join concept. Now you can observe, we can use the same query. You can see we can use the same query, but we can change the join connection. Irrespective of department name, I want to display all the employees, which employees are having departments, which employees are not having departments. I don't want to display only exact department details. I want to display all the employees which with department, without department. In that part I can use left outer join. You can observe left outer join or left join. You can observe here it will get null values as well. You can get null values as well. Here you can get 10, 20, 10, 10, 20, 30, and all the departments are matching. And you can observe here, if you can use right join, you can see what is the result will be deferred. You can see it will be displayed the right join, it will display the department name clerk. You can see in this clerk there is no employees, for this purpose we can get right join. If you can change the interchange the table names also, it will be working left join, then department, then employees. For that purpose also we can get employee and department. Now you can observe here, you can apply department, right? Department table, you can observe department table as D, right? And you can use left join employee as E. Now you can observe employees as E. Now you can observe, you can run last record. There is no employee and there is a department. There is no department related employees. This purpose we can use left join. For this purpose, if you want to display only which department does not have any employees, where e dot dept id is null, which employee does not have a, which department does not have any employees, can observe when I can execute 40 department does not have any employees. And also in the interview questions we can get, can you list out which department does not have any employees. We can use this query, and which department having all the employees is not null. So that 40th department record won't be displayed into the result set. You can observe 11 records, it will display 40 record will not be 40th department record, it will all be displayed, because we are writing a condition. I don't want to display the null values. For this purpose we can use join conditions. In that left outer join is completed and right outer join is completed, then we can go to the full outer join. Now we can use the same query. I don't want to use any where class. I can use full outer join. Now you can observe it will display all the records from both the tables. You can see all the records from both the tables, and which are null, which does not have null values. 40 department there is no employee records, so it will display all the either null or not null values. Okay, for this purpose we can use full outer join. It will display all the records without any condition. Then cross join, there is no keyword for cross, just we can use comma delimiter to separate the two tables. Then you can observe it will display 44 records. I have a 4 records in department table, 11 records in employee table. First, you can observe the 10th department. It will display 11 times. It will display 11 times. So each and every record multiplied with another table, each and every record. That's nothing but a cross join. Then finally, we can come into the self join concept. Self join is nothing but a table can be itself with different alias name. A table can be itself with different alias name. Join, we can call it as self join. There is no self keyword. Either we can use inner join, left join, right join, full outer join. We can use these joins. By a table can be itself joined as a self join. In this join, we can use to identify the hierarchical relationship on any organization by using self join concept. By using self join concept, you can observe here from employee table as E, and I am using a inner join, and I am using again the same table, employee table. Same table can be joined by itself with a different alias name. First table I am using alias name as E, and second table I am using alias name M. So in this part, we can call it as self join. Self join are mainly used to identify the hierarchical positions of a particular organization employees. We can get an interview question. Can I get an employee hierarchical information? So you can use self join. You can use left outer join, or you can use right outer join. As per your logical thinking, we can implement to write a joins. And final note of the joins, we can combine multiple tables within a single select statement based on the join conditions. Inner join, left join, full outer join, right join, and self join and cross join. These joins concept are very, very useful in our real time, and we can get interview questions like this type. They won't give you a particular tables or particular table names. Sometimes they will give table names or directly they can give you numbers. Can I get, what is the result? Can I get all these joins? Just they will ask. So you can prepare like tricky questions. You can prepare like that. Then you can observe null equal to null. You can remember this point. Null equal to null. No, null equal to never null. So we can get an expected result. It's not equal to null. 0 equal to 0. Yes, 0 equal to 0. It's right. But null equal to null is not right. It will not mapping null and null values. Simple example, you can observe. Why I'm telling like this? You can observe here. I have a table A. In a table A, I have a values like 1, 2, 3, null. Now you can observe. I have a table B. 1, 3, null. Can I get what is the output of inner join? Can I get what is the output of inner join? It's nothing but a 1, 3. Can observe 1, 1 is matching, 3 and 3 is matching, null, not matching. So in this purpose, we can use null equal to null, not equal to null. So this type of tricky questions we can get in interviews panel. So you can prepare this level as well as how we can identify the relations. Please follow the steps. To first, you can write, whenever you are working on the joins, first you can write a table name. Then you can start to writing what are the constraints columns we have, like primary key, foreign key, like ID columns, then table B, ID columns. Then you can map what is the common column between these two tables. You can write on condition, then these two columns, then start to write a query. Then it's easy to working on the joins concept. You can follow this rule. You can easy to understood the join concept. Also, you can write easy queries on the joins part. So please subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching this video. We will catch you in next session with new topic.